Brown, dark brown, black. The color scheme of my Negro body is simple. My hair is black, greased with oils from a motherland I can't relate or go back to. Brushed and combed, picked and twisted so it looks nice or acceptable, clinging to my scalp like a newborn, blossoming into strange fruit. And soon it will hang heavy over my shoulders, but no, that would just be tasteless, right? To have so much of what I consider pride on open display, and pride I say, but isn't a mask. Something dark enough to cover my face, muffle my ears, hide my eyes, keep enough of me away so I can never truly be stolen. My hair is black, like the tar on my ancestors' feet, like the nights they ran under chasing North Stars. My sixth great grandfather was white as the sun, which would be fine if my eyes weren't lynched bodies. Dark brown, burnt breathless, swaying in the daylight leaves me wondering about my mother of that time. How much of her skin was ripped under manicured fingernails leaves me wondering why those same damn hopeful stars didn't save her. How much pain did she swallow to pass these eyes on to me? And I see my brother, fist clenched to the sky, swinging at stolen air, hitting nothing but the seconds between him and his grave. And I see my sister, sprawled on kitchen tile, wrists spilling lifeblood because she knows the ground it falls on is not her native soil. And I see my skin is brown and my scars are black, so when enough body blows and bullet holes paint me as dark as my heritage, well, have you ever seen a man become his own shadow? Voices too strained to resist, hands too tired to raise, I reckon I'll know within my lifetime. How must it feel to be the black of a hashtag on another Twitter feed, to be forgotten and replaced by another black boy whose name resembles sin? How must it feel to be dark enough to fade away and black enough to never be a target again? Brown, dark brown, black. The color scheme of my Negro body is